2-2-1-1 lifetime against the Isles. 2.43 in those games. Rick DiPietro is 2-3-1 against the Leafs. 3.86, but he was absolutely sensational in the last.
The son of Steve Tambellini, who won the Stanley Cup here in 1980. Young Jeff was born 4 years after his father lifted the Stanley Cup. And there's a picture of Steve, who now is the assistant general manager of the Vancouver Canucks. And here is Jeff's first goal this year. He had 22 goals and 22 assists in Bridgeport, their American League farm team, before he was recalled.
Along the board, Sundin trying to muscle it in front. He does. Ponikarovsky shot is right down. The rebound jammed away. Another shot. And a big pileup in front of DiPietro holds it out. McCann lances it off the board. That's past the Islanders. And so there will be no icing. It'll give it away. Steve! Where's the puck?
Hit the defense.
They think it hit Campoli diving across. Holy mackinaw, what a chance that was. Here's Steve for Stajan. In front of Neal, and he shoots.
That's big in the NHL this year, but Campoli makes a big shot block after an awful giveaway by DiPietro. And that puck's going right in, and it hits him in the shin pads and stays out. And then at the other end right here.
And then Kilger couldn't corral it. Leafs get an extra net on the shot right off. Saved by DiPietro.
Big difference.
Get better soon.
Thanks.
All right, let's go back upstairs.
Here's a pass in front of the goal. DiPietro diving back, and he's able to hold it out.
Steve tried to bounce it off DiPietro from behind the net after the original shot.
It did it.
Well, let's have a look at this one as DiPietro gets a little luck here on the goalpost. Nice play right there by the defenseman to take the
off the goal post and into goaltender
DiPietro.
And Darien to try and put it through their chest, I guess. And just prevents it from getting by. Sundin intercepts an errant pass. Carries down low. Being checked there by Richard Park. Turned over, and here is Hilbert getting to center. Andy Hilbert in on the wing against Kavina. Kavina rides him heavily into the boards. Kept in at the point by the Islander. Hilbert.
1 minute left in the
second. Monikarovsky's back on a shot. Defense scores! Hunter in front of the net.
Trent Hunter gets his 16th goal of the season. Sean Hill keeps the puck in and just gets it on the net. A little wrist shot that would have been an easy save for Raycroft had it not been touched by Hunter, who just goes to the front, hopes it comes through, and tips it in.
So with 57 seconds left in the period, the Islanders, who are denied on back-to-back. And Andropov couldn't get a stick on it. A shot in front of Andropov! Rolls it into the goal crease! And a great save made there! There's a goal! Holy mackinaw! How did he score that? He shot it right along the goal line and into the net! Now wait a minute!
Are they saying that the whistle went? That would be the only defense, unless they just want to go upstairs.
Are they calling interference? Are they discussing it here?
Well, there was no question about the fact it went in.
It is. Oh, yeah. Now, unless they didn't see it. But Ponikarovsky with the chance. Andropov in. Let's listen and see if there's a whistle. No whistle.
You couldn't make that shot once out of 30 times if there was nobody else on the ice.
What? Are they calling it goaltender interference? He's trying to get out. Oh, if that is in fact the call, it's a terrible call.
You're talking to both teams here, whatever the call is.
Well, Sundin is the more upset, and so obviously it's going to be waved off. Carey Fraser, the official. Moves into the faceoff circle against Randy Robitaille. The Leafs win it cleanly. And it is played off the board by Kilger, but not out. He had a chance to turn and look up ice. Cody on the boards, back to the point. Cody rolls and shoots, deflected, scores!
Scored as the poke check by DiPietro wins the
happy? You betcha.
I would be if I was him. But it was a great hockey game, Joe, and it's too bad teams have to lose a game where both played like that.
Molson and Canadian, three stars tonight. Rick DiPietro, number three. Andrew Raycroft, number two. And Trent Hunter is the game's number one.
The beauty of the three-point system, you don't like it until you get the point for playing 65 minutes.
And so the Maple Leafs road trip will continue as they travel to Philadelphia to play the Flyers Saturday night and then into Montreal for a huge game against the Canadiens on Monday night. Sportsnet Connected is next for Harry Neal and Paul Hendrick. Joe Bowen saying good night from Long Island.
Period. Matt Stajan dropping to Alex Steen. Back to Stajan for the tip-in. Stajan scoring his first goal in 19 games as the Leafs get on the board first. And they keep it coming. Alexei Ponikarovsky throwing it on net. It goes up Brendan Witt's skate pass. Rick DiPietro with that. Toronto up 2-0. But back come the Islanders. Sean Hill lets the shot from the point go. Trent Hunter right there with a nice tip-in. And with that, New York is down 2-1 after two. To the third we go. Carlo Poliakovo throwing it on net. Nick Andropov tries to jam it in. It's cleared, though, to the corner. Matt Sundin puts it in from a bad angle, but wait. The goal is waved off because of goalie interference. There's another look at it. Paul Maurice cannot believe the call from the bench, but that is how it would stand. Islanders in the power play. Tom Pody, the point shot. It is tipped in by Hunter, who gets his second of the game, and that will tie the game at two. More New York pressure. Jason Blake with a chance at the side of the net. The puck comes to Marc-Andre Bergeron, but Raycroft making a spectacular save. Back the other way the action goes. Ponikarovsky passes up front to Stajan, but DiPietro kicks it away. Tied at two through regulation. This one needing overtime as well. Here in OT, Blake with a break. He wires it. You heard it off the post. Nothing solved in OT. We're going to a shootout. Yes, another shootout. First Islanders shooter is Miro Shatan going in on Raycroft, who makes the pad save. The first Leafs shooter is John Cole going in on Rick DiPietro. He is denied. Next up for the Islanders, Victor Kozlov. Nope, stopped by Raycroft. So we go to the second Leafs shooter, who is Matt Sundin. He moves in, goes to his backhand, but the great glove saved by DiPietro.
Wow
is right. Excitement all around. Third New York shooter, Randy Robitaille. There you go. He buries that one. So Alexei Ponikarovsky has to score. DiPietro, they'll come up with the poke check, and the Islanders win in a shootout. 3-2 is the final, and as a result, the Islanders have picked up a point in 13 of their last 15 games. They improved to 4-0-1 in their last five against the Leafs. Also a note about the Maple Leafs, Pavel Kavina leaving in the second period with a lower body injury. He did not come back to the game.
Okay, I got cross-checked into the crease. Did not have a job to stay out. Then their goalie grabs his stick and squeezes it in between his legs. I don't get it, and it doesn't matter if I do or not.
After the goal, the guy just cross-checked me from behind, and I fell, and that was it. But when Mats was shooting at the net, it was, you know, I was clearly out of, goalie's zone. So, I don't know. The only thing was there in my stick, because he grabbed it and, you know, put it between his legs.
He came to the crease, and his stick got caught in between my legs, and... You know, his stick was still in my legs when they scored the goal, so you can say what you want, but he's in on top of me, and they made the call, so we feel fortunate, but you got to live by it.
The Islanders with a big shootout win over the Maple Leafs on Long Island on Thursday night. The Islanders, one of the hottest teams in the league since the middle of January. They've recorded points in 13 of their last 15 games. It's a tough loss for the Leafs. We get more from James Cebulski.
The Maple Leafs were crying foul after Thursday's game when what appeared to be a goal scored by Matt Sundin was called back due to goaltender interference. Most of the Leafs felt that ultimately cost them a point in a critical game against the Islanders.
There's nothing that I can say about it. There's nothing that's going to change what happened on the ice. Their goalie, our guy got cross-checked into the crease, did not have a job to stay out. Then their goalie grabs his stick and squeezes it in between his legs. I don't get it, and it doesn't matter if I do or not.
The only thing was there in my stick, because he grabbed it and, you know, put it between his legs and left it there.
The puck came in, I think it was Ponikarovsky's stick came in between my legs and got caught up. And, I look over and he shot the puck, but when the puck went in the net, his stick was still tied up with me. So, He made the call.
Not all the Leafs felt that the non-goal cost them the win. Leafs netminder Andrew Raycroft pointed to the club squandering a two-goal lead, which led to their failure.
It's a big game, and, you know, this time of year, you just can't. You know, every little thing counts, and I don't think, you know, that if that's our excuse, it's not. It's unacceptable.
There's nothing we can do about it now, so we got another big game on.
I want to show you, all you people now, you know how I'm a Toronto Maple Leaf fan. I hate to say that. There's no sense of me beating about the bush, and I've said it many times. And when that goal went in the other night, I was, hey, Fraser's giving it to us again. Remember in L.A. and all that stuff, Gretzky and Dougie? Anyhow, I'm going to show you, he called a correct thing. And Greg Millen tells me, you cannot be in the crease and interfere. Now watch, you'll see the next one. See him kind of, see his stick in between his pads? The next one you'll see, he switches them around. Now, like, see, he's got a stick in between his pads. If you're in the crease and interfere with any way, see, like that, and he can't get over. So look at him go down, though. Let me touch him. Jeez, that makes me mad when I see that. Anyhow, Fraser made the right call.
No doubt about it. And here we go with all of